It's only been 6 months since we last had Menzi Mcunu in the studio. And in that short space, he's managed to impress us again by being listed in the Forbes Africa 30 Under 30 list. Wow. Creative category list. I mean, he's just incredible. He's also just returned from Italy, where he was one of the designers attending the Pitti Uomo Menswear Trade Fair 2020, which is hosted in Florence. He joins us to share his personal trends for the upcoming season. Welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
Firstly, huge congratulations on the Forbes 30 Under 30. What does that mean to you?
Thanks. It still feels very surreal. I've always thought of Forbes magazine as like huge authority in terms of business, and just to be on that list is really, it's really overwhelming. And for me, I just hope it can help me push my entrepreneurial ventures forward and just like push the African narrative.
Yeah, yeah, beautiful. So tell me about Florence for the men's trade wear show. What exactly happens there?
So Pitti Uomo was obviously the principal menswear trade show in the world, and there's people from all over the world. Everyone in men's fashion goes there, and that's where you see new trends and new brands launched, and everything to do with men's, the business of men's fashion is there. And it was really great to come and see, you know, the African agenda being pushed more and more people of color being flying out and taking part of it. And people from the African continent are really doing it. And there's a lot of international brands, African brands, that I think are on the world stage now. And
amazing.
I think for me, that's the most important thing.
What did you go for? Were you showcasing any of your collection?
No, I wasn't showcasing. So I was. There's a lot of connections you can make in PT and working with brands and like learning how to get into that international
arena.
There's no other event like that where you can make the connections like that. I also covered Pitti Uomo just for GQ South Africa.
Amazing.
And just on trends and what's happening there, and that was quite cool as well.
And I mean, you really are you are always so well dressed, so masculine, and just you're always so well put together. So this weekend is of course the Durban July.
Yeah.
What can we look out for? What do you think men are going to be wearing?
So with Durban July, it's quite hot. Durban's always hot, so winter fashion kind of goes out the window in South Africa. But I think we'll be seeing a lot of linens. I think we'll be seeing a lot of safari suits. We'll be seeing less skinny suits, but more like classic fitting suits. That's, I think, a real big trend I saw in Italy as well that's coming back. And I think we'll see a lot of color. I think it's an event where people want to stand out, and we'll be seeing a lot of punk tailoring in that way, and a lot of colorful shirts and printed stuff.
I really think because men kind of have quite basic options, I think they've got to play around with lots of interesting, you know, varietals. What is is there a theme for the Durban July this year?
I think it was something to do with African luxury.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what are you wearing?
I'm not going to Durban July.
Oh no.
I wish I was, but this year I'll miss it.
Well, look, you can literally just walk from here straight to...
I feel so much pressure. I need a new outfit, you know, new shoes, everything,
Yeah. What do you think men need to focus on when they think of being stylish?
I think it's important to focus on what fits your body. I think a lot of people dress to what's not their body, and that's one of the most important things. So just colors that suit you and just silhouettes that suit you. And I think that's, for me, that's the most important.
Well, you always look so fantastic. Thank you so much for being here again, and congratulations on all of your latest achievements.
Thank you.